Thank you, Mr. Chair. Good afternoon, Excellencies and distinguished guests. I'm here to speak on behalf of Myanmar Opium Farmers Forum, a member of Drug Policy Advocacy Group Myanmar, a civil society platform for more humane drug policies. Myanmar Opium Farmers meets farmers who grow coca and cannabis from other parts of the world at the Global Forum of Producers of Prohibited Plants in the Netherlands in January 2016. There they shared similar problems and recommendations, and here is what they have to say. We grow opium to ensure our basic needs, food, health, and education. We live in isolated and mountainous areas where it is difficult to grow other crops. We face difficulties to transport crops and access markets because of weak infrastructure and low prices. We also have no access to land properties. The majority of opium farmers are poor and grow it for our survival. By growing opium, we just become less poor. That is why we should not be treated as criminals. Opium has many positive and traditional values for us. We use opium as a medicine for diarrhea, cough, and pain. It also keeps us safe from poisonous insects. We even use it to treat our sick animals. Opium is offered to guests at social events such as weddings and funerals. We believe it protects us from evil and brings good luck. We demand respect for our traditional and cultural rights regarding opium use and cultivation. We already face difficulties to feed our family, and on top of that, we are threatened with forced eradication. Once the crops are destroyed, we have no income to live from, so we cannot feed our children and send them to school. Since we sell our harvest beforehand, we get indebted, and to fix this, we have to grow opium in the next season. Eradication also leads to corruption and conflict in our areas. Instead of eradicating our poppy fields, local authorities should provide basic services that are currently lacking. At the moment, very few of us have benefited from development projects. Only very few alternative development programs are in place. These programs should be designed with our involvement and suitable for the local environments and climates. To conclude, we want this UNGAS to stop treating us as criminals. Involve us in policy-making issues affecting our lives. Recognize traditional and cultural cultivation and use. Stop forced eradication. Improve and expand development programs with our involvement. Thank you very much.